Coach, is it safe to say 25 years in the making?
Yeah, it's 25, and you know, I was a junior in high school last time this program was in a regional, so it's exciting. It's awesome to be a part of it. Really special moment for us and all the people that support us.
Coach, did you ever think this would be a culmination at the end of just your second year in Thibodaux?
Yeah, we talked about it in the press conference. We talked about it in the team meeting last year, and we talked about it. We felt like coming into the season, we had a championship caliber team. We thought we had enough older, established players. We got a little taste of it last year down the stretch, and we got to the tournament, which was important. And so, yeah, I thought this could be realistic, but you know, to go ahead and do it is really special.
And to win this tournament in the fashion that you guys did, a real total team effort.
Yeah, I mean, golly, timely hits, really good defense. The bullpen was outstanding, quality starts each game. You know, we've been struggling on the mound a little bit, and so to be at our very best in the tournament was huge. And we always said that to win this thing, we have to play our best baseball, and we didn't feel like we had throughout the season yet. And so it was really exciting to be able to do that.
Talk to me about the play of one individual, though, Zane Washington, the tournament championship MVP.
Yeah, I mean, just want to talk about putting an exclamation point or a bow tie on it, whatever you want to say, just for his whole season. You know, Zane's been nails for us all year, and the bigger moments he makes plays, you know, whether it's an outfield assist or a big hit or runs one out of the yard or makes a dive and play, steals a base. I mean, he really does it all for us, and we wouldn't be in this position if it wasn't for him, and our players know that.
What can you say about Nicholls' play at the end of the season, but also big wins against a good baseball team, UNO, to get the regular season championship, and now again UNO to get the conference title in the tournament?
Yeah, well, I mean, just talks about their program, Blake Dean, their coaching staff, and their players. They're really good. It's scary. I mean, I'd love to tell you I felt good in the last inning. I didn't until we made that third out. They're such a potent offense and such a competitive group and gritty players, and just hats off to them. You know, I've been on the other side of this thing a lot of times in my career. And it's a painful feeling to be on the other side, but they're a really good program. With him and their leadership, they're in a really good place.
Talk to me about that first game in the tournament, though. I believe 14 innings, a conference record for the longest game. How did that set the tone for what came after?
Yeah, I mean, obviously you got to find a way to win, right, in that game. And we've been in those situations so many times. I think we won in 12 innings there during conference play to win a series. And then we won the 19-inning game, the longest game in Southern Conference history at Lamar. I think the more times you're in those moments, I don't know necessarily you're going to win. You just get more comfortable, right? And so our guys have been there before, and they just keep playing. And I think sometimes when you're in those situations as a team, guys kind of get caught up, and just all you got to do is keep playing. And hopefully somebody makes a play or somebody gets a hit or somebody makes a pitch to give you an opportunity to win, and we did that.
And in those long games like that, how hard is it to keep the team focused in those later innings to go after and kind of go for that win?
Yeah, not this group. No, this group's focused every day. Whether it's a good day or bad day, it's the next day, and they show up to practice focused, and I'm sure they're going to go out and enjoy this one tonight together, and they'll be focused when it comes to practice, and we find out where we're going for regional. They'll be excited to go play, but they'll be focused and prepared, and they're going to go out and do a really good job.
You know, we talk about it, the success of this program, and with you at the helm in just 2 years, was there ever a moment where you thought maybe you wouldn't take this job or that Thibodaux wasn't the right spot for you?
I mean, I don't want to say it was a thought. I mean, I thought there was going to be a lot of work to do. I mean, I was looking for an opportunity, and the more people said it couldn't be done here, and a lot of people said it didn't think it could be. My wife looked at me when I was getting those calls before I accepted the job, and she said, when are we moving? You know, I'm a low percentage guy. If you go look at my track record, where I'm from, I'm a kid from Hull, Massachusetts, and man, I don't think anybody from my town's ever done this. And you know, I've had a fight and claw and scrape for everything I've ever gotten, and I think we've taken on that personality here as a program, and we respect everybody and fear nobody. We're showing up to play baseball, and our players, they've taken on that mantra, I think.
Have you heard some of the projections being thrown around about maybe Nicholls in Baton Rouge? Mm-hmm. Obviously a big win the last bit of April over the number one ranked Tigers. Talk to me, does that matter to you? And if so, you guys, do you like that matchup?
No, I don't know. You know, I'm not going to go to bed tonight hoping we're playing anywhere. I'm going to go to bed tonight, you know, really proud that we've won two championships in the last week and that we're going to get an opportunity to keep playing together. Wherever they send us, we're going to try to do our very best. Look, there's so many really good teams, and you know, those guys up in Baton Rouge are under the gun all the time. Every time they lose, everybody acts like the sky's falling. They're one of the best college baseball teams I've ever seen in person. And so, I mean, golly, I know we'd have our hands full. I mean, we got run ruled pretty bad the time before. So we're really fortunate everything lined up for us that night. And if we go there, we're going to give it our best effort. And it's going to be about us and not about them and our dugout. And, you know, but we're just happy to continue to play. I mean, I don't want to make it about where we're going, who we're playing. We just get to continue to play together. And this is a special group, and I'm really happy about that.